Good morning, everyone. It's Not the Cool Mom. So I'm coming to you with my first fresh off the hook video in, I don't know, umpteen years. I'm not going to be on camera because you don't want to see that. But I'm going to show you a couple things that I've been working on since the last time I did a video. I've done a lot of stuff. A lot of it has gone to its new homes. So I'm just going to show you what I still have. So this right here is just a basic cotton circle. It's all scraps from cotton yarn when I've used on other projects. When I have a little bit left that I have not used from a project, then I just add it to this circle. My goal is to get it big enough to be on the top of the deep freezer that we have in the house, because we do have it kind of in a main area, so I want something to cover that. One, to try to keep things off of the freezer, but also so it's a little decorative and kind of protect the top. So as you see, I've just kind of been working in spirals all around, and each time I finish I add a color, and that's why I have all these different colors here. Here's some of my cotton yarn. I think all my cotton yarn is is it Sugars and Cream? I think is what it's called. I really haven't been able to find any other brands at my local stores, craft stores, but I do like working with this. That's pretty much all I've been working with during the summer. This is a Bernat acrylic, but it kind of feels like cotton. But in this bowl, I have rings that I have done from Haley's pattern. So here's three rings that I have done. She is Beautiful Butterfly 82 here on YouTube. These I plan on giving to the ladies at church. Haley, I'm hoping you'll let me teach your pattern to them. This is actually a covered solo bowl. I was in a hospital in June. So they would bring these with like little condiments whenever you get your tray. And I got bored in the hospital, so I just covered them. And what I've been doing is using them to kind of drop random things like my change from my pocket, earrings, things like that. Then I have this, which is a sampler of, or it's kind of sampler gauge, whatever, of Lucy's pattern from Attic 24. I've become like obsessed with her blog. Not with her, because that would be stalking, but I'm debating if I'm going to do a granny cover for my teapot that I got on Crochet with Raymond. She has a granny square pattern to cover the teapot that I am debating if I'm going to use. So that's the sampler to see basically how it's going to work out. I do like the pattern. I do kind of see how the crochet blanket that Lucy did was ridiculous, because I don't know if I'd have the patience for that. But yeah, that's the sampler. Then this is what insomnia and crochet gets you. So I was messing around because I couldn't sleep, and I started with a circle, and then I kind of worked off the circle, and to me it looks like a little badge. So I think I'm going to finish this off and use a little felt and sew something over here and make like a little award for my little girl. And then that way, you know, if she does good things or whatever, I can pin it on her and she'll feel proud. I did pick up this book from the library, and of course the first thing my daughter asks is if I can make this character. And I'm like, of course, she picked the one with the wig that uses the, oh goodness, I can't think of the type of yarn that you use to make the wig, but to me, that's the hardest one. But of course, she's kind of issued me a challenge of asking if I can make it, so we'll see what mommy can do. All right, then I'm going to turn you around, and bright light, sorry. I have been doing buntings or banners, so I have them all strung up here, and this is all
Attic 24's inspiration. So the first one up top, this one here, kind of like the shield pattern, that is Lucy's pattern. And I did it with all intentions of kind of doing what she did, was making the banner and then making felt letters and sewing them on. But after I finished, I was like, I don't know, because I was going to put happy birthday. I did enough to do happy birthday. But in my family, we have a whole lot of summer birthdays. So then I was like, oh, I didn't have time before the first birthday came. Then, because I finished that and I liked it, I did this one here. This is probably my favorite, the triangles, because I didn't have a pattern for the triangles, but came out pretty good. I think I started off with 16, maybe 15 single crochets, and then reduced to make the triangles. And the colors are so pretty, because it's like this bright yellow. Hopefully this is showing up right for you. And this kind of aqua turquoise color, beautiful. Then my husband was like, oh, okay, so is this mine? And I was like, oh, I didn't know he would want one in particular. So then I was like, oh, let me do circles and squares. So this is probably not going to show up right for you, but this is like a burgundy color. He really liked this color, burgundy, almost eggplant. And then this is a green. And so I did circles and squares. And let me come back here, because you can see that that one kind of is strung tighter, because I actually ran out of the burgundy color. I had used part of it about a year ago for something else, so it had to be a smaller banner. So yeah, so I've been working on, or bunting, whatever you call it. But I've been working on those. So I've been debating if I will make those for other people, because they do take quite a bit of time. I kind of did them in between a lot of sick time and lunch hours. So I don't know if I'll sell those. Not these in particular, but ones like them. But yeah, so that's what I've been working on. So if you like what you see, of course, check out Attic 24. I think it's attic24.typepad.com for this sampler. Also, that's found on Attic 24 and Crochet with Raymond. Haley's is Beautiful Butterfly 82. This is just a spiral circle, so you should be able to find random patterns on that. I didn't follow a pattern, so I can't tell you how to do it, but there should be plenty of listings there. And if you have any questions, just feel free to comment or send me a message. And of course, check out all the other Fresh Off the Hook family members. I'll list all of their links at the bottom of this video. Have a great day. Bye.